Spooky season is scary for more than one reason, but honestly, mostly, it's the waste. Between Halloween and New Year's Day, Americans produce 25% more waste than they do the rest of the year. This is physical waste, new items, emissions, and more. So let's discuss how to have a waste-free or less wasteful holiday season, starting with Halloween. Hello Evidence, I'm Matt, welcome back to my channel where we talk about all sorts of things, zero waste, focusing on free, easy, and fun ways to live low waste. If I talk a little bit too fast for you, great news, YouTube has a gear icon right here. You can change the speed of the video to match whatever you need, because this is just how I talk. I'm ready to go. I have my homemade pumpkin spice syrup in my mediocre iced coffee, my homemade apple candle. It's in an upcycled Bon Maman jam jar. And I've got my secondhand sweater on. So I'm ready for a low-waste fall, even though it's still the end of August here in northern Minnesota as I'm filming this. But let's get into it. First up, decorations. Halloween might be only one day, but I know plenty of people who decorate all of October and maybe even September and October and maybe even into November. And that's fine. Honestly, I think that's great that you keep your decorations up and enjoy them as long as possible instead of buying a bunch of stuff just to have for one day. And this usually comes with decorations for inside your house and outside your house and maybe your office or your classroom if you're a teacher. This year, let's be mindful about how we're decorating. First, use what you have. If you no longer like your old decor, declutter it and donate it. When looking for new decor, opt for something secondhand first. There are many cute items that you can find secondhand and honestly will probably be much cheaper and of course better for the environment. You could also swap decor with a friend if you have similar tastes. Or you could head to the thrift store in person or check online, especially in like local areas to you on Facebook Marketplace or your Buy Nothing group, for example. Now, once you have all of your actual like seasonal decor squared away, next step is to find decor that you can use all year long. Stuff like baskets or signboards, garland or something else. See if you can find a way to use that in your home all year long instead of just for a couple weeks or months. I also highly, highly recommend avoiding single-use junk, particularly those fake spider webs. Those make me so sad. They are fully plastic, not recyclable, often blow away, can tangle animals. They are very pollutive to create and dispose of, just so wasteful in general, so avoid single-use decor if you can. Now, the epitome of Halloween is pumpkins. They're a very popular decoration item whether you're carving them or not. And did you know that pumpkins are food? They are totally edible. It is the same pumpkin that you're gonna put in your pie in November. Now, not all pumpkins are gonna be edible once November 1st rolls around, especially if you carved them. Please don't eat a carved pumpkin. But if you just have an uncarved pumpkin sitting on your porch, it hasn't been, you know, rotting in high temperatures, or it hasn't gotten eaten by animals, it's totally fine for you to eat. And if you don't want to eat them, please compost them or find another way to dispose of them besides the landfill, such as digging a hole and burying it in your backyard, and then you might have a pumpkin patch next year, giving it to a local farm for the cows and the pigs and the goats to eat. And if you do want to try eating it this year, maybe you've never done it before, here's how I like to prepare it. I will cut the raw pumpkin into big chunks, peel on. It's so much harder to peel it when it's raw versus cooked. And then I roast it in the oven until it's fork tender. And then here, it's very easy to either just peel off the peel with your hand or use a spoon to get it out very gently. And then from here, you can take those chunks, eat them as it is, freeze them as it is, or turn them directly into something like a baked good, a pie, or soup or a curry right then and there. You can freeze the cubes, or you can blend it and freeze the puree. That way it's ready to go for baked goods, soups, dog food. I love to just give Danahi pumpkin as a food supplement, or eat it however you prefer. Especially if you have a lot of pumpkins or just a large pumpkin, I find that freezing it is a great way to use it all winter long instead of trying to find a ways to use it right this second. So if you can, avoid the landfill with your pumpkins. And also, I do not recommend that you just like chuck it into the woods. It could cause an invasive species breakout. It might make local animals sick. You never know what might happen. So compost, eat it, give it to a farm, or start a pumpkin patch in your yard. Next is lights. Now, we just really associate lights, or maybe just me. Maybe it's just me associating lights with Christmas, but plenty of people have lights on for Halloween as well. Maybe those big blow up pumpkins and blow up ghosts, or purple lights around your house. Whatever decorations you prefer, but be mindful about how long these lights are on. Not only because it's better for the environment to not have these lights running 24/7, but it's also better for your wallet. It can get really expensive to have these lights on 24/7 for one or two whole months. Here's some examples. You don't need your outdoor lights on during the day. Nobody will be able to see them. You don't need your lights on at 3 a.m. in the middle of the night. Nobody's going to be awake to enjoy them. So unplug them when they're not in use so that way you can still enjoy them without having too many emissions and also saving some money. Yes, we have pumpkins for Halloween, but I think the more iconic star of the show for Halloween is candy. Let's talk about how to have less of an impact with your candy in two ways. First being physical waste. Much of our holiday candies are not packaged in recyclable material. Even if it has a recycling symbol on it, doesn't mean that it will be recycled. Always check your local rules before recycling. Even then, generally speaking, most candy is packaged in thin plastic, which are rarely accepted curbside. Plus, they might also get dirty, they might get melted chocolate on them, or melted peanut butter, or melted sugar, whatever it might be, rendering it not recyclable. So avoid this thin plastic where you can, and if you do use thin plastic, just throw it away, stop wish cycling. Maybe you also just opt for candy in recyclable material like paper packaging, for example, Milk Duds or Sweet Tarts, or candy in aluminum like Reese's Cups. It's hard to find truly zero waste packaging, especially for those like bite-sized candies that you pass out for trick or treat, so do your best. And or you could opt for vegan candies. Vegan is inherently better for the planet, so if you want to reduce your impact in this way, pass out vegan candy. Some popular ones include Skittles, Dum Dum, Sour Patch Kids, and more, and if you want to learn about more vegan candies, you can check out this very old video. Now, it's not sanitary to pass out bulk store candy, but if you just want candy for you and your family to eat at home, shop at the bulk store. This way you can get candy package-free and in containers that you already have and will reuse afterward. Another idea for at home is to make homemade treats. Again, this is generally frowned upon to pass them out, but if you just want something to eat at home, consider making it yourself. A bonus tip in the candy category is to sort your candy when you or your children get back from trick-or-treating, because I don't know about you, but I hate after a couple days or weeks, my candy all starts to taste the same, right? Like my Reese's Cup will start to taste like Sour Patch Kids, and my Sour Patch Kids will start to taste like Milk Duds, and they all just kind of start to taste bad. So I think that if you were to sort them, you know, put the chocolate ones together, put the, you know, sour ones together, put the fruity ones together, they might all keep their flavor a bit better and last a bit longer. I haven't actually tested this. This is just a theory, but give it a try. Moving on to costumes for trick-or-treating or Halloween party, whatever you're wearing a costume. Costumes can be so much fun, but also very wasteful. So here are some options to avoid the waste. For your costume from years past, again, honestly, people probably won't notice. And if you do want a new costume, you could swap costumes with a friend. You could have, oh my gosh, I just thought of this. You know there's clothing swaps. What about a costume swap? That sounds so fun. We're moving, which is why I'm filming this video in August. We're moving to Northern California and we're getting there like late September. So I don't know if I'll have like enough friends or community established by Halloween to do my own costume swap. You could also shop for your costume secondhand, especially if you want something pre-made, because I know plenty of people go to like, what's that Halloween store? It's orange and it pops up in abandoned buildings. Spirit Halloween. Because it is easy to just wear a pre-made costume, right? So if you want a pre-made costume, shop secondhand. I see them all the time at stores like Goodwill and other small thrift stores. You shop around on secondhand sites as well, or you can DIY a costume. Again, another very old video, you can check it out up here, about some DIY Halloween costumes. If you want me to make a new one, again, I'll make it next year. But this is very eco-friendly and budget-friendly, using stuff you already have in your closet or just buying a few bits and pieces here and there. And I have been doing this since high school to save money, and it has been so much fun. I've been Mermaid Man and Barnacle Boy with a friend. I have been a Scarecrow. I have been Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. One year it was like wear your costume to work day at work, and I was very lazy and I did like a gardener. I just wore like garden clothes and an apron. I had like seeds and a trowel in my pockets. It was very, very easy. So you can truly go all out with these DIY costumes, or you can do something very simple. For candy buckets, I simply do not understand why people buy a new candy bucket every single year. I had the same purple one every single year growing up, and honestly, it was so fun getting it out of the attic and being like, oh, there's my purple pumpkin. I can't wait to use that again this year. Use your items from last year. Use that candy bucket from last year, or use something you already have. A pillowcase, a basket, a reusable grocery bag. There are many, many options for things that you already have in your home to collect your candy. And if you want something that matches your outfit, you could paint it, you could upcycle it. Or maybe you buy something brand new this year, and then you just have your children keep it for the rest of the years. Speaking of trick-or-treating, it is the event of Halloween. Let's talk about a few ways to make that event more eco-friendly. Instead of driving from house to house, if you're able to, park in one area and then do some walking around. Great excuse to get some exercise, get your legs moving, and of course, save gas. When we did this as a kid, we lived way outside of town, so we would drive into town, and then we would drive, like, you know, to one end, walk a couple streets, my mom would go get the vehicle and move it up, etc., etc. So we would do a little bit of driving, but mostly walk. If you're the one passing out stuff this Halloween, this trick-or-treat, as I already hinted at with candy, candy can be quite wasteful, and also there's already so much of it. Pass something else out instead. I got this idea from my friend Chris on Instagram. I will tag her down below. Last year, she passed out mini soda cans and mini water bottles. Now, the mini water bottles did come in plastic, but this is all fully recyclable. And also, who doesn't love a cold drink when you've been running around for hours? Now, you might be wondering, will those cans actually get recycled? Maybe, maybe not. So what you can do also is, with your trick-or-treat station, have a trash can and a recycling bin set up to help your friends and your family and your neighbors reduce litter and encourage recycling. Avoid passing out junk. I already hinted at this with decor. Those cheap plastic rings, pencils, you know, rubber balls, whatever it might be. Will people use them? Maybe for a little bit, but will they get used for a long time? I highly doubt it. Instead, stick to candy, stick to soda, stick to water, stuff that will be consumed. Yes, it's still a little bit of waste, but I think it's less wasteful than this gimmicky junk. Halloween parties can be a lot of fun, but also very wasteful, so let's try to avoid that. I've said it once, I'll say it again, bringing it back to decor, use what you already have, thrift something, try to buy as little new as possible. For food, make as much as you can from scratch or do it potluck style. Ask each guest to bring one thing homemade, so that way it limits the amount of work for everyone. And from scratch usually means less packaging and as little impact on the planet as possible. For drinks, offer drinks in pitchers or dispensers and then opt for reusable cups. Because if you didn't know, red solo cups are commonly not accepted for recycling. Or if you want single-use drinks, opt for cans instead of single-use pouches and plastic bottles, because cans are much more accessible to recycle, have a much higher recycling rate. When serving the food, also opt for reusables as much as possible. Now, you might be having a big party and think, I don't have enough plates for that many people. You can thrift some reusable plates. I did this when we hosted a lot in Okinawa. I literally just went to the thrift store, grabbed a bunch of like 25-cent plates, and made our parties as low waste as possible. This did help because I don't have like a ton of friends, but we did have, you know, upwards of 20 people at our house a couple times. So if you are gonna opt for disposables though, opt for something made from plants like paper, bioplastic, etc. My favorite brand for this is Repurpose. Now, if you are going to be having disposable options, cans, paper plates, etc., have an option for guests to dispose of them correctly. Make sure that you have a trash, recycling, and compost station labeled and clearly explain the rules to your guests. Make sure that you have a plan for leftover foods, whether that be you're going to keep them and eat them yourself, you're going to send some home with your guests, whatever it may be, have a plan to reduce how much of that is getting sent to the landfill. If you're sending out invites, do it digitally instead of a paper version. This also will save you money. It could be something as simple as starting a group chat and say, you know, hey, party at my house. Or you could do something fancy, create an invitation on Canva, send it out to people in their email, make it a little fancier. And if it is a costume party, encourage your guests to dress up as something that they already have, or this could be your opportunity to have a costume swap. Everybody brings a costume, everybody gets a costume at the door. That could be a lot of fun as well. Lastly for today is leaves. It's not necessarily Halloween themed, but fall themed. Leaves create habitat for animals, creates fertilizer for your yard for free, and really doesn't damage your yard. Unless you have a strict HOA that says no leaves, I highly encourage you to leave the leaves. And by leave them, I mean leave them. Don't mulch them, don't do anything with them, because mulching them will also kill the critters that are hiding in them. Not only does it provide habitat for worms, bugs, and small mammals, but these animals provide food for the entire food chain and really just benefit the entire ecosystem. If you have too many leaves, you can clear some of them and leave the rest. And when disposing of leaves, find a way to compost them, send them to a mulching company, instead of sending them to the landfill because that will produce methane emissions. And what a waste of a plastic bag. That is all of the ways that I could think of to have a low waste fall and Halloween, but leave your tips down below. I'm sure that this list is endless and there are many more options for a zero waste Halloween. I do have more holiday content that you can check out below. Again, I've got some costume videos, some candy videos, I've got how to have a zero waste Thanksgiving and Christmas and New Year's, all of which you can find below, and a lot of these tips are very similar, especially for like parties and decorations. So happy Halloween, happy waste reduction this time of year, hope that you're having a good holiday season with your family, and hopefully preventing some waste and saving money. I will see you in the next video, but until then, remember that your small actions make a big difference in the long run. Bye guys. I can't. Okay, focus. Focus. Are you sniffing? Are you sniffing this? Is that what you sniff? By the way, bloopers, this is my last video in Minnesota. Yeah, and if you still have yet to hear, moving to Northern California, see you there. Okay, where was I? I said one sentence. Is that just a squirrel again? I'm taking my sock off while I'm talking. Or something of the sort, instead of saying